So there's a research question format. This can be called either PECOT or PECOT. This is a research question structure. So here you'll have a population. This is the group being studied. Then you either have an intervention or exposure, what is done to the population. And then you compare the two populations, you have an outcome, and then over a certain amount of time. This is an easily understood design for studies involving interventions. For example, maybe drug testing or how someone will react to a certain medication or vaccine. And this is not applicable in observation studies. And then there's a PECOT structure for non-intervention studies. So the approach to your exposure equals how can we compare or stratify the outcome? You know, does the presence of, example here is, does the presence of dementia affect walking ability 1 year after a stroke? Here you have a variable walking speed, and is dementia present or absent? And you know, what is the relationship between cognitive functioning and walking ability 1 year after a stroke? And here you have walking speed, and then you can have a score, and you know, you're measuring presence or absence. And here is a PECOT for non-intervention studies. You know, again, it's the approach to exposure can is equal to how can we compare, stratify the outcome. So how much does walking ability among stroke patients with dementia decline in 1 year? Now here you have the same variable, walking speed. You have a baseline data and then another observation point 1 year later. So here, the time interval is important. So requirements for a good study objective. Whether this is format, either PICOT or PECOT, you know, this should follow logically from the study objective. So again, P is your participant, E is exposure or your intervention, C is the comparison, you know, what you're comparing. Here is like walking speed on the previous two examples, outcome, and then the time interval. So here's another example of a research question being set up. Time is optional here. But this study aims to provide a summary estimate of the extent to which cannabis use in adolescents is associated with the risk of developing subsequent major depression, anxiety, and suicidal behavior. This paper is taken from a psychology journal. So here the participants are adolescents. The effect, the exposure, the treatment is cannabis use. Comparison is not applicable, but they're looking at the outcomes. So the outcome can be major depression, anxiety, suicidal behavior. And time interval, I guess you can say subsequent. So just, you know, it's, you know, here you have cannabis use and then you measure it sometime after or later in life. So there actually is a time element here. So when the research question is clear, the study aim is also clear. Back to the dementia example, here are the participants are elderly people experiencing many memory lapses who have received a diagnosis of mild cognitive impairment, which is MCI. They have not been diagnosed for any other condition that may lower cognitive functioning. And the individual or family will consent to the participation of the elderly person. So the intervention here is remote aerobic exercise program using a tablet ergometer. And this is 30 minutes a day, 5 times a week over 8 weeks. Let me look back. The comparison is the tablet-based memory training. So they're actually going to take a little memory test. And the outcome will be the memory function, and then the time interval is 8 weeks and then 1 year. So they're going to take this test at the end. of their training regimen after 8 weeks and then a year later to look at long-term effects. So here the aim of the present study is to evaluate the preventative effects at 12 months follow-up of a remote aerobic exercise program and memory loss among elderly people diagnosed with MCI after seeking treatment for forgetfulness compared to memory training alone. Don't forget that you should be having a control group in here that are not exercising as well. So here is a well-written study objective. And you can design statistical tests and results and figures to be used. The aim of the study is to evaluate the preventative effects at 12 months follow-up of a remote exercise program on memory loss among elderly people diagnosed with MCI after seeking treatment for forgetfulness compared to memory training alone. So you have memory training and then aerobic exercise and memory training. So here you have main effect, and then you can have an interaction effect with time and the group.